Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to install and use a packaging SDK that will enable you to create standalone apps with the uDraper plugin for Windows. We are going to cover the following steps: how to obtain the SDK and redistribution license, how to download and unpack the SDK, how to prepare and package your app, how to access garments, how to activate your standalone app, and finally, how to handle override materials. Feel free to fast forward if you're familiar with any of these topics. You might have noticed that we've added a packaging tab to the front and pricing pages. Please note that the pricing is currently for early adopters and might change in the future. Packaging is intended for more advanced users, and it isn't a replacement for the developer versions of the uDraper plugin. Before packaging your project, ensure that it's already functioning as required in the Unreal Editor standalone window, and that you have the necessary prerequisites for Unreal Engine packaging installed and properly configured. Please refer to the Unreal Engine documentation on installing the required Visual Studio components. It's important to note that the uDraper packaging SDK requires Visual Studio 2022, so if you have an older version, please update it to the latest one. Additionally, ensure that all necessary components are installed using the Visual Studio installer. To obtain your packaging SDK, you'll need to log into your existing uDraper account and click on the Buy button. Make sure to read the description carefully, as the price and licensing terms may change. You'll need an internet connection and a new redistributable license to run your standalone application. However, please keep in mind that this license is machine locked and will only run on one machine at a time. If you have special licensing requirements, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. Once your purchase is complete, proceed to your personal account. You'll find a new entry with your prepaid redistribution license ID, which is highlighted differently to avoid confusion with your other uDraper development licenses. Please note that the development license should be placed in the Draper Simulation Component License section of your Unreal Editor, whereas the redistribution license is used only when activating your standalone application that you've packaged with the packaging SDK. We'll show you how to do that in the next steps. These are two completely different products, so please don't mix them up. To download the packaging SDK archives, head over to the Downloads tab where you'll find links to the archives. Keep in mind that we currently have three SDK versions available for Unreal Engine 4.27, 5.0, and 5.1. Therefore, you'll only need to download those that correspond to the EE versions you use. Let's focus on downloading version 5.1, which is a 7-zip file that you can extract using 7-zip or WinRAR. Now that you have the archive, you have a couple of options for unzipping it since we recently updated the way we install the uDraper plugin. Let's run the latest uDraper setup program as usual to install the uDraper plugin. In the past, the Draper plugin folder was simply copied into the engine plugins folder. However, with the latest version, we've changed our approach. Now, we create a shortcut in the engine plugins marketplace folder that points to the corresponding UE version in the 3D Draper UE subfolder. This new approach allows us to handle situations where both the development and packaging SDK plugins are present. One option is to overwrite the existing uDraper development plugin in the plugins marketplace folder with the packaging SDK. This option allows the packaging SDK plugin to work for all of your projects, but you'll need to repeat the process every time you update the development version of the plugin. Alternatively, you can extract the packaging SDK plugin directly into your project folder. Ultimately, it's up to you to decide which option you prefer. Let's walk through the entire process from creating a new UE project to packaging and running a standalone application with uDraper. You can choose a C++ project from the start, or if you choose the blueprint option, you'll need to add a C++ module later on. In this tutorial, we'll use the blueprint option. First, we need to enable the uDraper plugin and restart the Unreal Editor. Then, to prepare for packaging, we'll add an empty C++ class and follow the UE instructions. Once that's done, we'll close Visual Studio and the Unreal Editor and restart the project. We'll then rebuild the project. I'm going to open another project where we've already added a metahuman with uDraper components as a third-person character. Let's make sure that everything works correctly in the editor by playing this level. Once everything is working as expected, we can proceed with packaging the application. Select where you want to save the standalone app, and the packaging process will begin. Note that the first time may take a while, but subsequent packaging should be much faster. Before we run our standalone app, we need to make sure that it has access to the garment folders that we intend to use. For this example, we've used a dress located on the same computer. However, if you plan to run the app on a different machine, you should ensure that the app has access to the garments. One way to accomplish this is by placing the garments in the project subfolder. If you select the dress folder from the project folder, the folder path will have this macro. In such a case, you will need to manually copy your garments into your packaged app folder. Now, when we took care of the garment folder, we're ready to launch our standalone app. However, when we launch it for the first time on a new machine, we'll see a registration dialog that asks to enter your redistribution uDraper license that we've gotten at the beginning. You can paste your license and activate it, but you'll still see an error message and will need to restart the app. That method works, but it's not very elegant. Let me quickly deactivate the license to show you other options. I need to open Alloy Peers folder, start the command prompt, and run lean client p deactivate. So, another activation method is to execute physics remote service p. This will display the activation dialog, and you can activate your license there. However, the most flexible way to activate is invoking lean client p activate with your license ID as an argument there. You may want to use this method if you want to implement a custom activation method in your Unreal app. After activation, your standalone application should run as expected. It's important to note that if you're using override materials, you'll need to explicitly specify that these assets ought to be exported when packaging your app. For example, let's add a new material folder and create a new test material there. We have a detailed tutorial on how to use override materials, which you can check out using the link provided in this video's description. Now, prior to packaging, we'll need to open the project settings, go to packaging, and explicitly specify the materials folder to be included in the packaged app. Now our dress is using the native material that we've created. We hope you find this tutorial helpful. Thanks for watching.